各位来宾，本次大会将于一分钟后开始，请大家尽快就座，并将手机等电子设备调至静音状态。感谢您的配合。世界的对话不断演变，文字记载世界，交流打开世界，信息连接世界。当人类与 AI 对话，我们的探索没有边界。
Explorations have no bound.
人类的意识是怎样形成的？
How is human awareness formed?
外太空是什么样子的？
And what does the outer space look like? And do the outer space beings really exist? Where do humans come from? And what will be the future human society look like? And where is the edge of the universe?What is the ultimate dream of AI?
有请百度创始人、董事长兼首席执行官李彦宏。
Now, I would like to invite co-founder, chairman, and CEO of Baidu, Robin Li, to give us a speech. Let's welcome. Distinguished guests, dear friends from media, you are welcome to Baidu to participate in press release of Ernie Bot of Baidu. Thank you for your long-term care and support.
And
recently, many people ask me why we release this product at this time. Are we really ready? In fact, over the past decade, Baidu has invested in the R&D of Ernie Bot. And actually, its initial version has been launched in 2019. And actually, every year, a new version will be launched. And from this perspective, Ernie Bot is a natural continuation of our previous efforts. However, today's Ernie Bot, actually, our expectations for Ernie Bot is close to
可以说呢，全球的大厂当中，百度是第一个发布的。
And actually, for Ernie Bot,
那大家知道，微软是直接调用 OpenAI。
Baidu is the first one to launch such
Google,
a product.
Facebook, Meta,
and
Amazon,
others include Google, Facebook, etc. They have no same level product. So Baidu is the first company to launch such a product. And during our initial internal testing, we experienced the capabilities of Ernie Bot. And we feel that it is not perfect yet. However, why we need to launch it today? Because we have huge demands in the market. Because for various product lines, including search,AI cloud, autonomous driving, and Xiaodu. Actually, everyone is waiting for such technology. And more importantly, our customers and our partners are waiting for such a technology or product. So they are urging us to launch such a product.
Of course,
For the big model products, once they are launched, they will have feedback, real feedback from the users, and with the users' feedback, actually, they will iterate very quickly, and they will improve their capability very quickly. We hope that Ernie Bot will grow quickly and provide value for our customers and users as soon as possible so that everyone will benefit from it.
So
after all the hard work and
relentless efforts. Today, I would like to show you the pre-trained conversational AI bot, Ernie Bot. Okay, next, I would like to show you five demos to present you the capabilities of Ernie Bot. First is literature creation, second is business article creation, third is mathematical logical reasoning, fourth is Chinese understanding, the fifth is multimodal generation or creation. First of all, let's look at the literature creation. This is the interface of Ernie Bot. And let's look at an example of the science fiction three body. So first the question is, where does the author of Three Body come from? So
Ernie Bot
should know who is the author of Three Body and where does the author come from? And
the second
question, could you please summarize the core content of Three Body? And if we continue the science fiction, what perspectives we can have, and the Ernie Bot provides several perspectives. And a further question is, how should we continue the writing from the philosophical perspective?
And
Ernie Bot answers the significance of life, the ethical perspective. And the further question is, who are the actors of the film Three Body? And a further question is, what are the commonalities of the actors Yu Hewei and Zhang Luyi? And here is a list of the commonalities between the two actors. And another question, who is taller, Yu Hewei or Zhang Luyi?
Zhang Luyi is 3 centimeters.
Zhang Luyi is 3 centimeters higher than Yu Hewei. This is the answer from Ernie Bot.
So
during this round of conversations, we have 6 rounds of dialogues or conversations, and we can see, we can feel Ernie Bot has comprehensive capabilities, including summarization, reasoning, analysis.
For the
core content of Three Body, it tests the summarization capability of Ernie Bot. And for many facts, actually it is not difficult for a search engine, but for a conversational AI bot, actually there is a high probability of making mistakes. So it is not easy to answer those questions correctly. And actually Ernie Bot of Baidu also adopts the search augmentation and knowledge enhancement.
We have 550
billion
knowledge data,
so that we can guarantee that the answers from Ernie Bot will be basically correct. And next, I will show you the second demo, the business article creation.
The question
is, if we want to establish a high-tech service company with large model to serve SMEs, what kind of name could we give the company? The answers include 智信 technology, 智数智 云图. The further question is, 数智云图 is a good name. So could you please give us a slogan of the company to express the win-win concept?
And
please generate a newsletter for this company. with the limit of the word count within 600 words.
所以也生成了相应的这个这个新闻稿哈，那我就不一个字一个字念了。
A newsletter is generated.
所以这一轮呢，它是三
个 this round of
三个 round 的这个对话。
We have
那么大家可以看到呢，就是这里头涉及到相应的这种理解的能力、表达的能力啊，也包括一些这种创意啊、创作的能力。
Also creation capabilities.
这些能力呢，都是没有办法我们去一一的去教这个文心语的。那么怎么做到的呢？其实还是要有好的技术，要有大的数据。
Actually, we have good technology. We have big data.
那么文心语呢，可能除了千亿万亿的这个页面啊，用了几十亿的搜索请求啊，用了很多很多的图片，用了
pictures,
我们全部的知识图谱的这些个5500事实。那么在不断的训练的过程当中，那么就逐步的具备了一些比较丰富的能力。
So that they will cultivate their basic capabilities by themselves. And we can see that the number of parameters reached over 100 billion.
So
if we use the big data to pre-train them,
then
they can cultivate their intelligent capabilities by themselves. This is a good example.
好，我们来看第三个例子。
Let's look at the third example.
数理逻辑的推算。
Let's demonstrate the mathematical logic reasoning.
下面我们来玩一个鸡兔同笼的游戏。
Let's have a game of chicken and rabbit in the same cage. Now I input the question in the box.
因为生成式呢，确实需要输入很多词儿，所以我们为了节省时间呢，不现场演示，就是把它提前录下来哈。
那么，有多少只鸡，多少只兔子呢？
这个文心言说，这题好像出的不太对。
We could not figure out the answer. Maybe the question itself has some problem. So I modify the question.
好，解题思路是这样子。
And then, Ernie Bot provides the answer and also the steps of figuring out this answer.
所以啊。我们看到就是在这两轮提问当中呢、展现出来的能力是文心一言这个大语言模型它的数理逻辑的推理的能力这方面呢它不仅知道就是提出的对不对也不仅仅能够简单的解出来答案那么也给出来了解题的步骤、这就很像是
But also provides the answer as well as the specific steps to figure out this answer.
这样的能力呢，我们在过去这个一个月左右的中内测当中，其实不断的看到文心语言在进步。
In our previous internal testing,
虽然我们现在还不敢说是100%这类型的题都能做对，但是呢，它的能力已经是挺强的了。
And it has already very strong capability in the mathematical logic reasoning. And the fourth example I would like to show you is the capability of the Chinese language understanding because Baidu focuses on Chinese market. So Ernie Bot, compared with the foreign big models, has a higher capability in Chinese language understanding.
There's
a Chinese traditional idiom.洛阳纸贵 meaning the paper from 洛阳 is expensive.
当时洛阳的纸到底有多贵
What does it mean? And the second question is, how expensive was the paper from 洛阳 at that time?
大家也看到就是好像涨了这个两三倍吧。这个成语在经济学原理里头对应的理论是什么
What is the economic theory of this Chinese idiom in the modern economic principle?
好，最后呢，我们用洛阳纸贵来写一首《
Could you please write a poem with
洛阳城里春光好，杨业无双，洛阳纸贵，纸贵
，To write a poem with each character of 洛阳纸贵 embedded in each sentence of the poem, then a poem is generated.
So we can see that Ernie Bot has quite 熟悉程度，其实是相当的高的。
Capability in Chinese language learning. How about English learning? How about English language?
只不过呢， 确实要承认他的对英文的这种理解处理能力呢
Ernie Bot can also handle English language understanding, but we should accept or we should admit that Ernie Bot has a weaker capability in English language understanding compared with the Chinese language understanding. But in the future, we will further train Ernie Bot in English language understanding. And in the future, we will have opportunities to test it.
And
next,
这四轮问答。好，我们来看第五个 demo。
Let's look at the fifth demo, that is multi-modal creation.
请为2023世界智能交通大会来创作一张海报。
Create a poster for 2023 World Intelligent Transport Conference.
也很贴切。
And Ernie Bot creates a poster very quickly. And second question is, what are the cities most suitable for the development of intelligent transport? Shanghai, Beijing, Guangzhou, and Chengdu. And the third question is, could you please read the above content in Sichuan dialect? Ernie Bot, read the content in Sichuan dialect.
交通需求量大的城市，接下是一些可能适合的城市。第一，上海，作为中国最发达的城市之一，上海拥有着繁忙的交通网络和多样化的交通需求。智能交通可以帮助缓解城市交通压力，提升城市交通效率，改善城市居民出行体验。
Okay. We can stop here for this dialect.
好。请将以上内容生成视频。
And please make a video out of it.
最适合发展智能交通的，应该是那些具有较高人口密度、经济发达、交通需求量大的城市。以下是一些可能适合的城市：一、上海，作为中国最发达的城市之一，上海拥有着繁忙的交通网络和多样化的交通需求。智能交通可以帮助缓解城市交通压力，提升城市交通效率，改善城市居民出行体验。二、北京，北京是中国的政治中心、文化中心、国际交往中心。
好，大家看到生成的视频呢，也是非常相关，而且还
挺美。
所以我们这一轮呢，这个四次交互啊。分别看到它可以用文字生成图片，可以回答相关的问题，就是有一定创造性的问题，可以用语音方言。大家就是我们演示了四川话，其实它广东话、东北话、闽南话什么也都能讲。最后呢是用这些内容来生成视频。
Finally, it can generate a video out of the content. So for the first three items here, they will be available for all Ernie Bot users. And for the fourth one, it is not available to everyone. But I believe if you are a creator of Baijiahao, it must be very familiar to you.Because like every day, tens of thousands of Baijiahao articles would be converted to videos automatically and distributed on Baidu's platform. So we have connected all of these technology points together. Through these five demos, I believe you've now a basic understanding of Ernie Bot. After today's press release,You will be given an invitation code to experience all these features yourself. So from Ernie Bot's performance, we can tell that they could, to some extent, understand and express natural languages just like humans, and they can also do some reasoning. And all of these features are being improved continuously.Sometimes we may feel really surprised, but of course sometimes we can identify some mistakes. But one thing can be sure, it is progressing so fast. In the near future,
it will still witness very fast changes and progresses.
And we're going to fine-tune
the Ernie Bot model to make it adaptive to all Baidu products so that in the user's interface or in terms of user's experience, Ernie Bot can show its strong capability and its user-friendliness so it can draw closer all Baidu products to their clients and users. So Ernie Bot model will become an indispensable tool to enhance efficiency and productivity for everyone, for every company. It's kind of not possible for any company to develop such technology within months. So Ernie Bot is actually based on decades of Baidu's hard work and R&D efforts. So if we're going to further explain how was Ernie Bot developed, then I need to share with you my understanding of changes in the IT industry recently. While we used to divide IT technology stacks into three layers, chip layer, operation system layer, and software or application layer, in the era of PC and mobile internet, it was all these three layers. But as we enter into the era of AI, the technology stack of IT is now further divided into four layers. First, you can see the underlying layer would be the chip layer. It used to be dominated by CPU, but maybe in the future it will be dominated by GPU. And as we move upward, it would be the framework layer, just like Baidu's paddle platform. And as we move upward further, we have the model layer. And now, Baidu's Ernie Bot is located on the model layer. People asked us why we name it Ernie Bot or why we have product like Wenxin Yige. There are actually all models on the model layer. And in the future, Baidu's products will be developed based on these big models on this layer. In the future, search or chats or some other applications would all be developed based on such big models like Ernie big model. And every day Baidu receives billions of search requests, and that means Ernie big model would serve these billions of users in the future. And it is kind of conversational AI bot or generative AI bot. And why am I talking about the change of such IT technology stack? That's because conversational AI bot or generative AI bot really consumes computing power. It requires huge computing power and big models and also massive data, and it is quite expensive. And between all these four layers, they would be coordinated quite harmoniously, and this kind of synergy will be optimized to make it much more efficient than other systems so that the cost can be remarkably reduced, especially the synergy between the model layer and the frame layer. And in the past months, we've already experienced the benefits out of this quite good synergy between these layers. And what I really want to say here is that globally speaking, companies who are leading in all four layers can be so rare. And maybe Baidu is the only one. So Baidu enjoys quite unique advantages. And I believe in the future, in terms of the iteration speed of Ernie big model, you can feel so. You can feel that kind of unique advantage. When we officially announced the launch of Ernie Bot on February the 7th, over the past month, we've already noticed that more than 650 companies announced that they would join Ernie Bot's ecosystem. That means many companies have come to understand that this would be a very
big opportunity that any that can't be missed by any company, because conversational AI bot represents a new technology paradigm, and that will bring us an explosive growth of market opportunities, and also the release of business value would be exponential. And in terms of positioning of Ernie Bot, it is definitely a general grounded model, and on the basis of that, there would be like energy big model, transport big model, a media big model, and all industry specific big models to serve each and every industry. So Ernie Bot is not only influencing search, not only the IT companies, but also each and every company in the world. And because of its super powerful NLP understanding, expression, and reasoning capabilities, it enables all companies to become closer to their customers. That means any company could use such powerful capabilities to create better user experience so that they can retain better their users and they can become more competitive. So for these companies, or for any company in the world, Ernie Bot would be a very good opportunity, or even for each individual, Ernie Bot would be a very good opportunity. There are estimates that by 2030, brain workers would have their productivity or efficiency quadrupled because of artificial intelligence, and there would be an irreversible change to the nature of their work because of AI. So for the release of Ernie Bot or the release of such a conversational AI bot, what kind of investment or industry opportunities can we see? There would be at least three types of opportunities. The first would be the new type of cloud computing. As we all know, that the mainstream business model of computing, cloud computing, is as infrastructure as a service, provided by mainly public cloud based on the computing power. And today, if you are going to establish a computing center, of course you need a large amount of computing power. But in the future, I believe the new type of computing, cloud computing business model would be based on MaaS, model as a service. Future applications will be built on models, on big models, not only on infrastructure. So this will be a totally game changer for cloud computing. It will change the rules of the game. For the basic cloud services in the past, it would mainly rely on your computing power, your storage capability, but in the future, it would all depend on models and how your chips, applications, and models and frameworks have been coordinated together. And Baidu's AI cloud would make use of such concepts or such structure to offer services to all walks of life, and hopefully all industries can have their efficiency significantly enhanced, and they would seize a lot of business opportunities. And maybe in 2 weeks, AI Cloud would have an independent press release to give you more details on relevant products. It can be both public cloud and private cloud deployment. And the second type of industry opportunity would be about the fine-tuning of the industry models. We have industry-specific big models because we think there might be a middle layer for each industry, because all industries have their quite specific and unique data or knowledge. And if such data or knowledge is integrated together with the grounded big model, huge creativity and productivity would be generated. And maybe that kind of capability cannot be owned by Baidu. Maybe those data would not be provided to Baidu. But Baidu offers the capability to fine-tune such knowledge or data to avoid mistakes and to make the models more adaptive to each and every industry. And the third type of opportunity we can see is about the application development. We've already witnessed those from our demos. And this kind of generation capabilities based on Ernie Bot's super powerful understanding and expression capabilities, better applications will be created. So in the future, applications will be the key, not only the basic services, not only industry services, but the applications, the general applications. Because we've already WeChat, Douyin, or Taobao, such applications, and in the era of AI, I believe more phenomenal and new products will be created to make people see that more milestone events will happen. And finally, I would like to say that after the official launch of Ernie Bot, we will have a closed loop for feedbacks, users' feedbacks, together with the developer's model iteration and the developer's mobilization of resources will all be integrated to boost the iteration of our product. And what I want to say is that Ernie Bot is not used for the Sino-US conflicts of technology. It is representing the dream that we pursue as technology developers, and that is also what we would like to use, a kind of platform for us to use to empower all industries and clients and users, and it is the best testament of development driven by innovation. And thank you for your support and understanding.
当仰望星空时，你在想什么？我在想象未来可能是什么样子。当有人执着地发问，就会有不曾想象的回音。从方寸之间到寰宇之外，创造新宇宙的人相信永远看不到天花板，他们是坚定的创造者，他们不为到达而停下，用创造的脚步丈量未知，他们坚信不肯停留的人总有前方，世界从不会自己焕然一新，推动世界的引擎是创造者的坚定，百度始终与创造者站在一起，从嫦娥奔月到祝融探火，在未知的路上，答案终将在探索中浮现。未来的样子哪有一定，是你们决定了世界的模样。以上作品由 AIGC 和人类设计师共同创作，未来由坚定创造。
有请百度首席技术官王海峰。
Next, I would like to invite CTO of Baidu, Mr. 王海峰, to give us a speech. Distinguished guests, dear friends from media, good afternoon. You are welcome to the press release of Ernie Bot of Baidu. And just now, we have officially launched Ernie Bot, the large language model, and we have initially experienced the strong capabilities of Ernie Bot. And if you get the code, you will better personally feel the capabilities of Ernie Bot. And today, we know that it is an AI product, it is a large language model, and behind it is the full stack layout of AI. And Baidu has consistently laid out for 11 years, and now, each layer, we have very advanced products and technologies, including chip layer, framework layer, model layer, and application layer. And
层到层的反馈。
Between the four layers, we have layer to layer feedback, and especially for the framework layer and the motor layer. During our development, their coordination and optimization play an important role.
文心大模型以及它下边的框架层的飞桨。
Including the pedal on the motor layer, and it is industrial level open source platform. And in this area, we have accumulated many complete models. And first of all, I would like to share with you pedal platform. I think some of you are quite familiar with pedal platform
and
about its deep learning framework and its model. We have 10 years accumulation, and now we have a complete industrial level open source platform, and we have gathered 5 million developers, over 200,000 enterprises, and 60,000 models,
and AI 人才输送给各行各业啊。
3 million AI talents have been cultivated on pedal platform. For this complete platform, its core is the framework.
标准的深度学习框架呢，
a standard framework of deep learning includes development, training, and flexible layout. For development, we have integrated development model, and it is both static and dynamic. And in terms of training, it is the core content of the deep learning model. And today we talk about large language model. Now the scale of many AI models is increasing, and they have the training capability.
And
in the models, besides the training, we also have the industrial level data processing capability. After training the models, the most important thing is to put it into application in different software and hardware environments and in different scenarios. So we have much specific work, for example, the compression of the models and the forefront and the layout work,
蒸馏啊、剪枝啊、压缩啊等等等等，才能适配到不同的。
After a lot of work, we can assign them into different scenarios.
很多做深度学习开发的高手呢，
and for many developers in deep learning,
开始用这些框架来开发自己
的应用。但我们对整个飞桨平台的观察发现，其实
大多数开发者其实并不需要从最底层框架开始，而是要用已经我们提供的模型库。
They just utilize their model base.
不管是自然语言处理，今天我们发布的文心语言就是一个自然语言处理的模型啊，包括计算机视觉啊、语音啊、推荐啊等等方面，我们积累了非常多的产业级的模型库。
We have accumulated.
这几年我们着重发展的就是大模型，就是文心大模型。
嗯，
在有了框架。有了模型库的基础上，
For Ernie Bot, we also have the large language model, and besides that, we provide very abundant toolkits to support the developers to develop and lay out successfully.
那我接下来跟大家分享一下文心大模型。
Next, I would like to share with you
文心大模型呢，我刚才已经提到我们2019年发布第一个文心大模型，其实就是一个。和今天的文心语言一样，是属于自然语言处理领域的一个模型。文心这个名字呢，其实也跟这有关。文心的文，这个大家不言而喻知道是语言文字的文，而心呢，我们更多是
model。
因为第一个
，the two characters 文心文 means language。
文心大模型发布呢，其实一个自然语言理解的模型。我们希望我们的技术能用心的去理解语言。
Will understand language with our heart. So the second character of Wenxin.
当然还有一个典故大家都知道了，刚才我们看文心语言的 demo 也看到，它对中国语言文化还是有 很不错的理解。
Watch the demos.
另一个受众也是跟文心雕龙有关。当然，文心雕龙呢，
Ernie Bot has a very strong capability of Chinese language learning.
我们真正去细致的把这样一个文心大模型做好，被打磨好。
Is also associated with 文心雕龙。
在应用中呢，也发挥更大的价值。
Which means the traditional Chinese.
自然语言处理模型，我们现在已经。
Understanding capability. Now we have developed Ernie Bot from the first version to second version to third version.
呢，我们其实也有很多某一个方向，比如说我们有跨语言的模型。
And we also have the cross-language model.
做过代码的 Ernie Code 啊，也有这个图网络模型。还有一个很重要的，其实跟今天的发布也有关，就是我们还有一个对话的模型叫 Plato， 这个呢已经在我们很多产品里已经在广泛应用，取得了很多的这个应用成果。所以呢，正好这个时间也特别巧合啊，前两天刚刚中国人工智能学会发布这个吴文俊人工智能科技进步奖，我们是。历史上第一次拿到了
人工智能吴文俊
人工智能科技进步的特等奖啊，就是这个我们这个对话式的，而且是知识与深度学习相结合的这样一套
对话式的。The AI China AI Society has granted 吴文俊
计算机视觉的模型
Technology Progress Award to
这里既有跨这个视觉和语言，比如刚才我们看到的自动生成
Vision and Language Model。
文图生成的这样的一个模型啊，也就是大家可能已经
熟悉的 Just now we also watched the demo，
同时呢也有语音和语言这种跨模态，
audio and video generation model，
语言跨模态等等这些，同时也在延伸到其他一些领域。
And we also extend to other areas. We know that in recent years, AI technology has been applied in biological area，
计算的大模型。比如说进行化合物表征的学习，进行蛋白质结构的预测等等这些。
The prediction of the protein structure.
这是文心模型的基础层，就是基础模型啊。在此基础上呢，我们也已经跟很多行业伙伴在合作。
And now we are also cooperating with many industry partners.
发布了相关的这种行业大模型，比如说
，we have released some industrial level large models.
这个能源行业的模型啊
，For example，
跟浦发银行合作呢，浦发百度文心它是一个金融领域的模型。
We have the models in the energy and finance field. I believe that in the future we will cooperate with partners.
In
various industries, to jointly develop industry-specific models.
And
we can also provide related tools and platforms. For example, how to label and process data, and how to fine-tune the models. And just now, we also mentioned the supervised fine-tuning.
今天呢，我们发布的是文心一言。文心一言呢，大家从前面两页也能体会到了，实际上是基于百度这多年的这个人工智能领域，包括尤其是深度学习平台和大模型的这个积累啊，一个水到渠成的。
It is a natural achievement of Baidu.
而文心一言我们在开发过程中呢，主要一方面基于 Ernie 系列模型，其实我们就从 Ernie 的这个。
It is based on Ernie model, and we start to train Ernie Bot from the knowledge enhancement.
And
we also train the conversational
延伸到文心一言里面。当然，在做这个过程中又有很多新的改进啊。在此基础上，
主要有
六个核心的技术模块啊，有三个呢是什么大家广为人知的。相关领域的模型都会用到的，包括我们在我们的 Ernie 和 Plato 里已经一定程度上都用了相关这些技术，就是有监督的精调、人类反馈的强化学习以及提示的这个贡献。还有三样呢是百度很有特色的技术，就是一个是知识增强，基于我们世界上。据我现在知道的这个知识图谱里啊，规模最大的目前有5500亿条的庞大的知识图谱啊，来做知识增强。另一方面呢，基于百度，
做的这个中文搜索引擎，当然不仅仅是中文啊，一个非常领先的搜索引擎里边的一些能力来做检索增强，还有一个就是基于我们在对话技术方面积累做对话增强。
And we also have the conversation enhancement.
有监督的精条，我相信这个很多朋友都知道。但我们呢，做的过程中，除了用标准的这种有监督的这种精条技术，
We not only have the standard supervised fine-tuning technology, we also have many technology innovations. For example, for the Chinese language,
our model
has relatively stronger ability in Chinese language learning compared with the understanding of other languages. So relatively speaking, our training in Chinese language understanding is stronger than other languages because we have more data labeling
and
we select the data based on the traditional Chinese language and culture to train our large language model. And second is a service application, and Baidu has many C-end applications.
用户和客户的这些服务呢，我们也积累了很多对这个应用需求的理解。在做这些精
调数据的时候呢，也这些理解
呢也发挥了作用啊。再有一方面就是富含知识。
Providing process, such understanding plays an important role.
我们不仅仅是把知识
knowledge graph,
就用在这个模型的我们叫知识增强这过程中啊，同时我们也用基于知识图谱来产生了很多事实证明很有效的这个用于进行有监督精条的这些数据啊。
Data used for supervised fine tuning based on our knowledge graph, and
这个呢。在应用中其实至关重要，但是我首先得承认啊，这方面我们技术已经有一套完整的技术，而且运转起来，证明它也是有用的技术。而但是呢，这方面其实我得承认，为什么呢？因为我们真正训练的要充分，实际上是真正投入使用过程中，用户的需求、用户的反馈不断回来。我们才能更好地把这个反馈形成闭环。这个也是刚才
赵
飞说，我们虽然说现在还有没那么完美，但是我们早早地推出，在这个用户使用的过程中呢，我们会加速进步。那这里头呢，就会分三步：第一步是接收到人类反馈，然后呢，我们用这些反馈数据呢，我们会训练有奖励模型。有了这个奖励模型呢，基于这个奖励模型，我们再做这个强化学习时的这种策略优化。第三方面就是提示，就是大家可能熟知的这个 prompt。我们做这个呢，对于我们知道一个非常庞大的，比如说有千亿以上参数的这样一个大语言模型，其实里边已经蕴含了非常丰富的数据、非常丰富的知识。那么这些知识呢，就像你到一个到国家图书馆，里边有非常非常多的数据、非常非常多的知识，你怎么找到你合适用的呢？这时候其实还是有很多。要做的事情，这也是现在这个语言模型技术做上来以后能智能涌现的，其实一个根本原因。那么呢，而这个提示怎么样构建的更好，就会直接影响最后这个语言模型所表现出来的这个能力。而当一个用户的输入来了以后，我们可以基于很多自动构建的方法，比如说给它补充上实例，比如刚才赵斌演示这个极速通融问题，假设说你不清楚它怎么解，但是你给它一个例子，告诉它是这么解的，系统呢就是逐渐会学会这些东西，可以给它实例。比如说你要做创作的时候呢，也许可以给它提纲，给它规范，同时呢，大语言模型。这个大家很多人听说过，这个语言模型能做很多事情，同时也会有错误。那么我们如果把一些已经知道的准确的知识点给它也带进去，有助于它 表现得更准确。
Input,
这时候呢，
more accurate knowledge points into it,
包括我们这个检索增强也好，
the knowledge graph
都会起作用。再有一个就是大家熟悉的这个概念，就是思维链，这些也会构建在这个体系里边。
Be optimized.
好，
the whole thinking
三项大家相对熟悉的技术。我已经给大家做了一个简单的分享啊，接下来讲百度很有特色的。首先，第一个就是知识增强啊，我们的整个文心系列大模型，我们就叫知识增强的大模型。这个知识增强一直是我们非常重视的。总体来说，我们通过知识增强呢，对于一个模型，我们可以使得它效率更高，效果更好。比如说，我们可以用更少的参数，达到比它大得多的参数，甚至超过比它大得多的参数的模型的效果啊。同时呢，训练效率也更高。那怎么做到的呢？这里有两方面的技术，一方面叫知识的内化，另一方面叫知识的外用。内化简单理解一句话就是，我把这些知识在训练过程中用进去，把它内化到模型的参数里面，这叫内化。而外用呢，就是在模型参数里并没有内化进去，但是呢，我可以在用的时候，在推理过程中
While we're using it,
去用一些
during the reasoning process,
外部的知识啊。
We can use some external
这里头的内化，一方面是我让
make a contribution
这个大语言模型，或者是其实文心系列还不只是有语言模型，也有其他的跨平台的模型。
Of course,
我们通过在训练过程中，
cross-model,
不仅仅是把它就随机的切成串，
other than
而是先把它切成语义单元，基于语义单元来学习，进行语义学习。这时候效率很高，而且效果也好。另一方面呢，我们也可以通过知识图谱来。
And on the other hand, through knowledge graph, we can construct the training data to achieve knowledge internalization. And for externalization,
it might engage
knowledge reasoning based on the knowledge graph, and we can construct prompts based on the knowledge we have.
第二方面是检索增强。
And secondly,
大家知道百度在搜索方面有很领先的技术，也有这个每天数以亿计的人在使用的搜索引擎产品。搜索引擎呢发展了20多年，从其实基本的这个技术原理，底层技术原理其实一直是比较稳定的，就是简单说就是基于关键词匹配和链接分析啊。这样一套技术，这个链接分析，其实之所以有百度，也是因为认为有这个链接分析的专利啊。而发展到今天呢，其实，在搜索引擎这技术也在变迁。从2010年左右呢，百度就开始将深机器学习技术引入到搜索。2013年呢，把深度学习技术也应用到搜索。而现在又10年过去了。其实搜索架构我们也在发生变化，大家看到这是我们新一代的这种基于语义理解和匹配的这种新一代搜索架构啊，可以简单理解为我们一方面用一个文心模型，这个 Ernie 来理解快瑞，另一方理解这个用户输入，另一方面呢是理解这些文档啊，这是我们通常我们把它叫成一个双塔模型啊。基于这个理解之后呢，我们再做匹配，这又是一个文心模型啊，这样一套架构。而这套架构呢，和现在文心一言的文心系列的这个模型架构，它就本身天然的就有这种密不可分的关联。而当我们要做生成模型的时候呢，也之间可以进行联合优化，这样呢，我们可以把检索里边的一些有价值的结果，比如说一些精准的信息，带进生成里边去，使生成的效果好。
Can be used for the generation.
第三方面就是我前面提到我们在对话方面有很多积累，这里边呢就有几个重要的点。一是我们知道对话不是一个答案一个问题一个答案就完事了，是有上下文的，所以这种记忆机制很重要，同时也要对上下文进行理解。而如果一段长的对话呢，还有涉及到对话规划这样一些技术，这些呢就是我讲的这个文心言的主要的技术。简单总结一下，其实既有这种大家都知道的技术，也有很多百度特有的技术。当然这些技术呢，尤其是百度特有的这些技术呢，我们现在已经应用在文心语言里，但是还相对有还这个训练的还不够充分。我相信后边这些机制有了，会越来越发挥出更强大的这个能力。好，
make it even more powerful.
这个大模型本身啊，我就跟大家分享到这儿。最后我再说一下，我前面也说到了，就是深度学习框架这一层和大模型这一层之间做联合优化，其实是非常有价值的。那么非讲的也支撑了文心言它的整个从训练到推理部署，它使得文心言它效果更好，效率更高，而且性能也更强。从开发训练的角度，我们既有这种前面也提到过啊，比如说这种动静统一的开发模式，自适应的这种分布式架构，包括我们多维混合的并行策略啊等等。同时呢，我们因为这个训练的硬件环境呢，其实也是很复杂的，我们也能做这种硬件感知的这种自动优化、异构设备的负载均衡等等，有一系列的这种非常非常领先的这些。
So Paddle
开发训练的技术呢，都在文心言的这个模型的研制过程中起到了很大作用。当然了，这个模型出来要部署，呢，又涉及到很多，比如说怎么样高并发、弹性的这种服务化的部署。而且大家都知道，因为现在这种类似像文心言这种大模型技术呢，其实它推理过程中对算力的消耗也是很大的，所以这时候包括飞桨，包括更基础层的这个芯片怎么样进行联合优化，使得它的这个推理效率更高，其实是至关重要的，不仅是一个成本问题，也是能更广泛，只有它效率更高才能更广泛的应用。这方面呢，我们过去的一段时间已经取得了很大的这个优化的这个进展，而且已经还有很多新的已经储备了的技术已经初步实验验证了，也能继续提效，也在不断的会源源不断的上线啊。这些呢也都离不开推讲的这个推理部署模块的很多很多。
And that cannot be done without the reasoning and deployment modules of Paddle Paddle。
我对文心言技术分享就到这里啊。最后一页，这个向在场的所有嘉宾以及线上的所有朋友，我很高兴地向大家宣布啊，我们从今天起就会开始进行邀测啊。邀测呢，既会有这个个人用户，也会有这个我们百度智能云的客户啊。这个也希望大家收到邀请码以后呢，积极地体验百度的文心一言，和我们一起去不断地去帮助他成长，也让文心一言给社会各界、给我们的所有的用户和伙伴带来更大的价值。好，谢谢大家。
Bigger size of value to all of you. And thank you very much. This is all from me.
开场的时候提出了一个问题， AI 的终极理想是什么？
What is the ultimate dream of AI? And AI's ultimate dream is to bring more freedom and...
各位朋友，百度文心言新闻发布会直播环节到此结束。
Now we end the live streaming.